Welcome to the Global Academy Virtual Open Event 2020.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Global Academy. My name's John T. Archibald. I'm the principal here at Global Academy, and it's really lovely that you've joined us this evening. We're coming live tonight from one of our wonderful studios here at Global Academy, and maybe one day we'll be able to invite you in and actually take you around the school. So Global Academy, what's it all about? Okay, it's, you know, this is an amazing opportunity. I'd like to thank you for joining us this evening. It's been strange times in education for students and staff, and we know that. So what have we done over that time? We've made sure that throughout this period, we are maintaining a high quality education, and we will continue in the future if things would happen again. My main concern has been being able to keep students and staff safe. And if you come into Global Academy at the moment, this is what you'll see. One-way systems, things like this. We have done this so we can maintain the high quality provision that our students can get at sixth form. So why choose Global Academy over another sixth form? Well, because we teach a practical, hands-on approach, preparing students for a career in the creative and digital media. Also, joining Global Academy means you're joining something, part of something really big, okay? So, you know, behind me is the advert that's just recently gone out for Global. So you're joining the biggest commercial radio station in the world, who are our sponsors. So Heart, Classic FM, Capital, LBC. And in a minute, you'll probably see in the background some of our students in this advert who participated in the filming. But what also does that bring? It means we're part of something big, access to industry, access to partners, access to workshops, access to resources, and all through the specialist facilities we have here. Also, our other sponsor is the UAL, the University of Arts London, and of course, they bring their own expertise helping students for a life, maybe within university as well, because we are helping students for a career, either in jobs, in work, apprenticeships, or within university. So sixth form support and expectations. We are very different to some sixth forms, but we're also very similar. We have very high standards and expectations of behavior. And those behaviors are the ones that you'd see in the media company or in business. And we expect that from our students, because we expect you to be able to work in the business. We also have the same support systems for sixth form. So SEN department, revision, interventions. However, we don't do this without working closely with the industry and bringing it to life. So in a moment, I'm going to share a quick video about an example of how we worked with Global Media and the Creative Mentoring Network. Students had the opportunity to work with professionals at the top of their game and able to, over a course of 6 months, work and learn from them.
The end of 16 weeks of mentoring with Global and celebrate the journey of our mentors and mentees. We invite a few of them to come up on stage and share their journeys.
Before this experience, I didn't think I had it within me to like do something like I presented tonight.
I've gotten so much out of it. I've gotten connections, more confidence.
And now they have someone outside of the Global Academy to go to.
It's been the best experience, and I'm going to obviously keep in touch with my mentor soon.
Are all teenagers really tall?
Okay, that's just a taster of some of the opportunities that you have in sixth form, and we'll be showing more later. So just before I hand over to the rest of the show, we're going to show you a day in the life of one of our students in year 12. We'll also be taking questions at the end, so please feel free to add some comments and ask some questions, and I'll be back at the end of the show. So here we are, a day in the life of a year 12 Karina.
I'm Karina, and I'm a year 12 student at Global Academy. Welcome. So So I now have a visual lesson with Geordie where we get to practice with all these sort of cameras.
Currently recording a show for Youth Choice, so come on in.
Here we are in another lesson. This is my digital artwork I'm currently working on. In my free study period, I come in here to learn about all the skills needed for the media industry. Thank you for joining me in A Day in the Life. Now you've got a taster of what it's like. We hope to see you next year.
Oh, what a fantastic video. Hopefully you got to get a bit of a taste of life here at Global Academy and you get to see how there's no real normal day. It's lots of very exciting things happening every day. You're probably thinking that guy on screen's changed. That's correct. This is not John T. Hello. My name is JJ and I am the Director of Specialism here at the Global Academy. Now, I have a fantastic opportunity and role where I get to work with our teams to create amazing opportunities and career-ready opportunities across our media specialism at the school. Working directly with industry and creating the best opportunities and career routes for our students when they leave. My actual role before I joined the school was at Global. I was part of the sales team, working across promotions, branded content and live events. And before that, I actually was a producer on Capital and did some bits with Capital Extra. But I've always been really interested and passionate about how and getting involved in helping young people change their lives. And when this opportunity came around, I jumped at the chance. And 4 years later, here I am telling you the story. So I'm here today to talk to you a little bit more about our specialism here and the media side of things we do at the sixth form here at Global Academy. But before I do that, I thought it'd be really useful just to give you some background about the creative industries. It may not be a sector that you as a parent maybe have a lot of knowledge about. Well, let me tell you, it is really, really exciting and a buzzing industry. So we've actually seen a huge growth in the sector. So in the part, you know, expected in the next 10 years, it's going to be over 1 million new jobs in this industry, which is fantastic. And you're at the joining the school at the right time to really get ahead of the game and learn the skills necessary to join the industry. And we've seen huge growth already. The industry have grown massively in the last couple of years. There's more people working in the creative industries than they are in finance and energy, renewable sectors. There's been a 30% growth in the last couple of years from 2011, 2018. And more impressively and reassuringly, let's just say, 87% of creative jobs out there are at low risk or no risk of automation. So do not be afraid. We need you. We need your creative ideas. The robots can't do it all. So that's a bit about the creative industries and hopefully put your mind at rest about why this is an industry that you should be part of. Let me take you through a little bit more about what happens day to day at the Academy and the media course. So in year 12, all our students study a broad and rich curriculum here at the Academy. We do this so you leave the school with a wide range of skills and abilities across these four main media pathways. First up, we have digital. Our students will use the Adobe Creative Cloud, Illustrator, Photoshop to learn the real basics and get a good grounding in digital content production, whether that's graphic design, websites, user experience. Our students will learn the basics to really create some really strong media products. Our students also learn audio. So our students will get to use some of the 8 fantastic radio studios. They'll get to create content. They'll get to create their own radio shows. They'll get to create imaging. That's the bit that goes between the songs with when say station name. And they'll get to be really creative with podcasts too. So we have digital, we have audio. We also have visual, okay? And that's our version of TV and film. So you might be hearing these amazing TV studios. Okay, to you, it's just a green it's a screen at the moment, but trust me, if you're here, there's lights and cameras everywhere. Our students get to use some of the biggest and best kits to create their own content and their own productions, whether that be a short film or a trailer recut. And then what's really important is we have our enterprise stream. So enterprise at Global Academy is really integral to what we do, and it binds all our pathways together. Our students learn about audience and branding and content, because actually you could be the best radio producer in the world, the best film director in the world, but if you don't have the understanding of audience and content or how to sell your product, you're not going to go very far. Now, that's all underlined with our really rich work experience, career guidance, and what we call G-Talks, which is our industry talks program. That forms the bedrock of all everything we do in year 12. Now, moving into your second year, and sorry, I forgot to add, all of that makes up the UAL Level 3 Extended Diploma. It's an industry-recognised qualification, and after that can take you through to many places, whether that be apprenticeship, straight to employment, or into higher education. It's an industry-recognised qualification that's accredited by the University of Arts London. So you're seeing your first year, you get that real wide-ranging mix of skills, which will really set you up for the future in the industry. Then in your second year, you get to choose your pathway. So you get to try everything in year 12, and we actually find that students maybe join us with a kind of preconceived ideas. I'm gonna only love digital, I only wanna do digital. Then they grab that camera for the first time, or they get in the radio studio for the first time, and it changes, and they go down this different pathway and they get inspired by something else. So your first year is discovery, it's making mistakes, it's learning, it's finding out what's your passion. Then in the second year, you choose your pathway. So you, again, you choose the digital, the audio and the visual, and your lessons are then focused on that pathway. You work towards what's called a final major project. So that's a summative project at the end of each year, and that's what gives you your final grade. And if you think about the course, it's all about road testing and gaining the skills so you can complete that final major project at the end, which is an industry standard project that you complete and gives you the final grade to help you with your next steps, whether that be university or a job. Now, all of that again is underpinned with our industry program, whether that be a G-Talk. At the moment, we're having to do some of those virtually. Our careers program, only this morning, my colleague Sophia, who you'll meet shortly, was doing a fantastic session with our year 13s about personal branding and the importance of branding as a creative in the industry. Or our careers guidance program and our next steps program. So that's kind of your year 13 module. What we also do is we do something called Media Extra. So if you're on the audio pathway, for example, and it's really important you keep your visual and your digital skills hot and fresh, you do an hour or two of that a week as well. That's really important. So that is your course. That's what you do here at the sixth form. There's also the opportunity to layer that on with additional A levels, either in music technology or in drama or in art. So some students elect to do an additional A level on top of that, but the main qualification is equivalent of 3.5 A levels. So it's a bit of a meaty beast. It's definitely something to get yourself your teeth stuck into, but really gives you a huge, wide ranging opportunity to experiment, explore, collaborate, be creative and work in team. So if you're liking the sound of this, keep listening. I'll tell you in a minute how you can apply and join the course. So that is our sixth form offer. As well as the stuff we've talked about in the lessons across our four pathways, we have a lot of what we call extracurricular. So we have our school radio station, Youth Choice, which you can listen to anywhere in the world on a smart speaker or connected device. You can listen to our podcasts, which are on the Global Player or any other platform. But you can get involved in that. You can get involved in our activities in the studio. You can hire out kits. We have a wide range of specialist film and audio and digital kit. And also we often have work experience. We have students working on projects. We have, you know, opportunities to meet and work with industry or our mentoring program, which you saw at the start. So lots to get yourself involved in. And even more so, we're delighted to announce our partnership with Adobe, which means that every student here at the Global Academy gets free access to the Adobe Creative Cloud at home. Now this, trust me, is worth a lot of money. So that alone is a reason to come and join us. So you get access to industry standard kits that people are using in their day jobs, and you can use it for free at home as well. So it's amazing. So you're on board, fantastic. So you do your 2 years, and then what happens next? So you're probably thinking about what happens afterwards. And for us, career and destinations is so important. So on the screen now, you'll see some of the many destinations that our students go to, life after the Global Academy. So each year, some of our students take on apprenticeship roles at Global. So they might be working on the marketing team for Capital, or they might be working on video across Radio X or Smooth, or working across all of them. And some of our students then go on into full-time employment afterwards at Global. So we've got people working on the podcast team at Global Player, marketing coordinators across the business, working as producers on Capital. So lots of opportunities for our students. But it's not just Global. Oh no, they go off into many different other companies as well, including the likes of Google, Facebook. We even have students, alumni now at TikTok. And working on feature films like with Disney and the BBC. And we'll be hearing from alumni shortly who is doing an apprenticeship at the BBC as well. So our students do really well. They go off into fantastic destinations, whether that be apprenticeships or jobs, but also into higher education. So our students go and land roles at top universities on creative courses, on film courses, and do really well with that as well. And we're here to support you with workshops, talks. You have an individual media mentor, which is kind of equivalent to probably what your form tutor is in your current school. So you get that. They're here to support you every step of the way. So hopefully that's given you a little taste of life here at Global Academy. And if you do want to apply, it's really simple. Head on to the website and you can sign up, and we'll be talking a little bit more about that shortly. So if you have any more questions, myself and John T will be answering them. You just need to type them in the questions box on Facebook or on Zoom and we will answer. But if your question is, how can we see it? How can we get into the building? Well, unfortunately, it's not quite possible tonight, but do not despair, because we have got your ticket to your backstage tour here at the Global Academy. Let's have a look.
Hi, I'm Sophia and I'm one of the Vice Principal here at Global Academy. I'm delighted to be joined by two of our Global Academy graduates. We have Natalia Deer, who is a broadcast apprentice at Capital FM, and Navia Tor, who is a marketing apprentice at BBC. So Natalia, let's think about all those years ago. What was it about Global Academy that made you want to join?
Well, personally for me, it was that it explored a sector of media that other state schools didn't. If you think about it, like, yeah, this was 4 years ago, but I was in year nine and media was, okay, we're looking at a magazine or a movie, whereas coming here to Global, it's not looking at just that, it's looking at a whole industry, everything within the industry to actually set you off for work, and it's actually giving you more opportunities into different areas that I didn't even know about at the time, which for me, when I got even that little glimpse, I was just like, no, I have to be there, like, that's what I'm meant to be.
Excellent. Now you've achieved your goal as apprenticeship at Capital FM. Can you tell us how Global Academy prepared you for the role and what you currently do now?
Well, currently now I'm looking at different imaging. So that's sweepers and jingles on radio ads. So like in between the presenters and in between the songs. And being at the Global Academy, what prepared me for that was listening out, looking at different stations, imaging, mm-hmm. looking at the different type of sound effects, how they create different feelings and different connotations. So I feel like me listening into that and me practicing myself to create those different tones and styles of like different stations is what prepared me for kind of what I'm doing now.
Excellent. Now, Navir, can you tell us about teaching and learning in sixth form and what makes it unique?
Yes, yeah, so the one thing that really stood out to me was the fact that work experience was something that was really pushed, and the work ethic within itself, because I think compared to my normal state school that I went to before, it was mainly about the academics, mm-hmm. whereas this school really pushes on the work experience and like the actual ethos that you actually have to face when you're at work. And also I really enjoyed that the fact that the teachers have also gone through the media industry as well. Now they want to teach us what they've learned, and I think they've always been a great mentor as well. So if, for example, I wanted to do business, I could always go to a business teacher and they would always like mentor me and help me throughout what I needed to get through to get to that goal, if that makes sense.
Excellent. So if any young person's here watching, what advice would you give them about applying for sixth form next year?
Yeah, so I would say if you're definitely passionate about media and you're serious about getting a job in this like industry, go for it, because I think global within itself is such a great point where you can get connections. And I think if I definitely continued with my old state school, I wouldn't get the apprenticeship that I've gotten now. But because of the school, I've gotten to meet people. I've actually got to spoke to people in the industry, like have a coffee with them. And it's just been very insightful. So I definitely, if you're really serious about getting a job in media, definitely
Excellent.
Would go through
Thank
it.
You. Right. Next up is our VT on Only at Global. Thank you.
The Global Academy is a media school and we do things like visual, audio production, music production, and we learn about industry and business and the whole enterprise side of it all.
My experience at the Academy, it kind of helped me find what I actually was interested in. You're getting to become an industry standard.
Well, we have connections to going to movie premieres and we're meeting people there, people who are in that industry and the top of their game.
I've done a few events with Global themselves. I've done like Homegrown or Jingle Bubble, like really big events. And got to help out in like quite big roles, so that was really fun.
If you have a passion for media or just creativity in general, this is such an amazing school because the teachers here, the students here, everyone will just help you thrive.
You just kind of get this gut feeling, like I came here and you just saw the facilities and just like, there's no way I can't take this opportunity. I mean, you just look around and you can feel it as soon as you walk in the door.
And welcome back. You know, I love that video when it talks about the moment you walk inside the door, you just feel it. And I think that is so, so true. I'm joined back again by John T, the principal of the Global Academy. We've had some questions that have come through the Facebook chat and through Zoom. So I thought we'd kind of ask you some questions. In your opinion, what do you think is the best thing about the Global Academy sixth form?
Well, I thought it was interesting you talked about the feeling you get when you walk through the door. I mean, I certainly, you know, got that feeling when I came here from having been ahead of a, you know, a mainstream secondary school, came here, I thought, actually, this is a different way of learning. It's a different way. And I think that's one of the best things here. We learn from industry. We expect, you know, high levels behaviours and appropriate professional expectations. And I think that's one of the best things. And also, I think every day is very different and we're very flexible about what we do, and especially at the current times. You know, for example, you know, we had I think the studio below us, we had some, you know, dancers using our studios. We've had some people in this week using our radio studios, and we're very good at being very flexible about work experience. I mean, you know, our two students talked about the work experience, and I don't think you get that anywhere else, because we are, if something happens, we are very, you know, we will grasp the opportunities. I think working within, you know, the global media organization has brought so much. You just feel it all around. And, you know, if you go to, you know, Leicester Square into the global offices, it looks very much like us. I don't know if we look like them or they look like us. Anyway, but it's, you know, that's the kind of...
The canteen has the same name. Both called GFE, so that's part of it. So you mentioned about being flexible. So kind of, do you have a bit of a backup plan? Obviously, you know, students want to join next year if we're still in this space, in the pandemic space. Do you have a bit of a backup plan around kind of school closures?
Well, we were, I think, in a fortunate position, being a media school. We were up with all the latest technologies. So being able to deliver lessons through Teams or Zoom or through our Canvas platform, our online portal where all the work is kind of stored and students can access that. You've already mentioned the Adobe suite. So all students get that Adobe suite to download the cloud so they can continue with their work, whether they're here or at home. So we're ready already to kind of to be that virtual. And again, like at the moment, we have students coming in days where they're not meant to, you know, not timetabled to come in, but they're able to come in, use our facilities in a safe way. I mean, you know, we're maintaining our sort of safety throughout this. So if we did have to close down or lock down or anything like that, we are ready to just switch to a very virtual
way of working. Yep, I agree with that completely. Okay, some more questions come in. Uniform. What's the uniform like in the sixth form? It's non-existent.
Well, it is.
Not a school uniform.
It's not a school uniform. There's no blazers or ties and things like that. We are a media school. We expect students to look like how you would look like a media company in a media company. So appropriateness. I think it's always about appropriateness. Yeah. our two students, it was brilliant to have them tonight because, you know, Natalia has just come from work at Global, and that's what you look like.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's what we expect. Yeah. Obviously, you know, there are things like, you know, no ripped jeans, but you wouldn't do that in a company in office, anyway.
Yeah. Okay, so questions coming around kind of diversity and how kind of accepting are students and staff of each other? Is there kind of much diversity within the student body?
Yeah, I think when I talked about what's special about Global Academy, about the relationships and that kind of feeling here, is absolutely we have students from all over the country, all over the world. Sometimes we've had students apply from other countries. We're very accepting. We have a zero tolerance on bullying, homophobia, those sort of things.
Racism, so
absolutely, and you have to look at our staff as well. I think our staff reflect that, and it's all about respect, being able to respect, and we're not afraid to produce work on challenging our topics. We talked about through our PSHE what we call global cultural learning. I think it's an amazing place.
Okay, some more questions. Do we have to do all the pathways in the media?
When you come, and you talked about this before, so we run the UAL Level 3 qualification in sixth form, and within that, we give you a broad experience to those pathways. Yes, you do, because it's really important, and actually speaking to some students today, they learned a lot from doing a bit of audio. Even though they were passionate about filmmaking, they learned a lot about audio within film, digital skills. It's about making sure students have lots of skills for the world, you know, creating websites. You may want to create your own website. Obviously, when you move into year 13, you're able to move into your specialist pathway. And that's where you can actually start to really specialize. So if you are really passionate about audio, you can, you know, use your time there.
And I'd echo that kind of from my own experience before I kind of join the world of education, actually knowing my way around the different, you know, knowing my way around a camera. I might have been on a radio project, you know, I might have a band in the studio one day, but actually knowing how to take a good shot for the website, as an example, having those transferable skills industry is really, really important.
I think it's really important in the current, you know, climate about being multi-skilled and being able to have lots of those skills and being able to show that. I know that our students that go on are really well recommended now because of that. But also that kind of exposure to the profession, the way in which they able to present, they probably present a lot better than me, actually. You know, they can stand up in front of cameras, they can present, they can pitch, they've worked with industry. You know, it's amazing. You know, we took some students, didn't we, to the BBC, and they pitched their ideas to the BBC. You know, it was amazing to see them. Yeah.
And we work with brands like Nike and Coca-Cola and McDonald's, and students have worked with their marketing directors.
Other TV stations are.
Yeah. okay, so if they want to, say, for example, just do A-level English or something like that, something that's nothing to do with the media industry, we would recommend this isn't the right sixth form for them.
No, if you're looking to for a more broader education and you're not quite sure where you are and you want to do maybe English, maths,
psychology, history,
no, we don't do. We do run a couple of complementary A-levels. I think Navia did A-level English. Natalia did a maths A level. We do run those.
Yeah.
So those, it's quite a lot of work because that means you're doing four A levels because the UAL is equivalent to three A levels.
And I think the A levels on offer next year will be A level music technology, A level drama, and A level art. But they're all subject to kind of availability and interest. So I suppose if you've got no desire to work in the media, this isn't the place.
Maybe it's not working to me, but if you've got no desire to work in a creative, you know, lots of our students, I mean, if you look at some of our students that went on to university last year, they've gone into journalism or they've gone to broadcast journalism. Mm-hmm. They've gone into something creative, filmmaking, or they've joined one of the UAL. You know, I know that one of the students got a place doing fashion design at London College of Fashion. You know, it's about
set design at Rosebery Food. If students have got no experience of doing that, maybe their school hasn't done that in the past, or they've not, you know, if they, what do we look for in their application, let's say, to kind of,
I think potential.
Yeah,
you know, we're looking for potential. We're looking for someone who's probably done, you know, at secondary schools. I know a lot of secondary schools now are the creative subjects are being cut back. If you're able to only do art at your secondary school, but you've got a nice portfolio you want to show us, it's about potential, creativity, and that thirst and that passion.
Yeah, and it may be that you've created your own YouTube channel or a meme account or Instagram or a TikTok that's popping.
We always ask. We say, what's your social media following? Yeah. We ask, what have you produced? You know, and I will follow them or they'll follow me and we'll have a look at that.
There we go. So question around how full on is the timetable in sixth form? Is the workload quite high?
You get, like three A-levels, you'd get about 15 hours of tuition, formal tuition. At the moment, because of the lockdown and people travelling, we've cut that down a bit. But in the normal times, you get about 15 hours of tuition guided. And then you'd be in for 4 days a week. So there's plenty of time in the rest of the time where you can use our facilities and self-motivate. We would promote the fact that you could bring your own laptop in, work off your own laptop. Again, we're giving you Adobe.
We've got lots of breakout spaces.
Sixth form area, nice sixth form area. And we do trust. There's a sense of trust here. So in the studio we're in now, you can't see it because it's green screen, but students will learn and be able to book out this space and be able to work behind the camera or in front of the camera.
And on the course, is there any kind of exams or is it on the main media course or is it all coursework based?
It's mainly coursework based, but they get your final grade at the end of year 12. You do the diploma and you do a final major project. So that is where you can create using your own brief, working to the UAL spec. So you get your diploma. At the end of year 13, you'll do your final major project for the extended diploma. And if you get a distinction in that final major project, that's worth 164 UCAS points. So 3 A stars, and a merit's worth 120. And they get accepted in all the universities that Absolutely. They apply to. Yeah. Everyone got their first choice last year if they applied for university.
Yeah. And finally, in terms of students that are looking to apply, do you have to live in the area? Do you take any students from the area?
No, we do take students from the local area, from local schools who come here, but we have a wide range of students that come from all over London, but also into, to the west, towards Reading and Ascot and Surrey, to East London, to South London, and we've got a student coming in from Suffolk and Hampshire. So there's a great commitment that we see from students because they want to, want to be here, want to travel. And that's like the world of work. You will have to travel to your work, to your place of work, and you get prepared. But students are very, I find them very motivated. They'll work on the train. They'll be uploading things. Yeah, it always impresses me how committed they are.
Totally. So hopefully that's given you a bit of a taste, a bit of a flavour, and inspired you to maybe come and join us in the sixth form in September. If you are interested, you want to apply for a place, if you go to the website, click apply, and then we'll be doing virtual interviews in the coming weeks to secure a place.
Again, I would say, contact me if you have got any queries, and we hope to be able to maybe do some tours as well quite soon. If you really want to come look around, we can probably do some sort of individual tools so we're not breaking any kind of rules. But because I think it's an exciting place to come and learn and study, especially and to work.
Well, we'll leave you with a short clip of some of the work of our students, and hopefully we'll be seeing you very, very soon here at the Global Academy. Good night.
Thank you.
Got vertigo falling down, 'cause you're going to my head. Can I recognize the sound?